We are back here on Thursday Night Tailgate, and we're turning on our spotlight on the positive. Bob, who are you spotlighting this week?
Well, Chris, we're continuing to work our way through the list of Walter Payton Man of the Year Award nominees, and tonight I wanted to bring up the Atlanta Falcons nominee, and that's defensive tackle Grady Jarrett. Was reading some of the things he's done over this past year or so, Chris, and amazing he's been in the league just a few years and what kind of impact he's had already. First of all, he's very big down in the Atlanta area, Chris, about the anti-bullying campaign he has. It's called Big Men Don't Bully. He works very closely with the Atlanta Police Department and a police teen mentoring program down there, and he's always talking about talking to kids, and he's gotten a lot of his, he has a lot of conversations in his own locker room as far as getting his teammates involved in causes like that, various social justice committee things he does with the team. And so he is one of these guys, Chris, he is, and we talk about a lot, one of these guys that doesn't want to talk about things, he wants to get out in the community and do it, as opposed to guys so-called taking knees and things like that. He instills the importance of just getting out there and make a difference. You know, no talking, no symbolism. Get out there and do it. And he does it. And ever since he's been drafted by the Falcons, he's a Georgia native, Chris. So he finds it very necessary to give back. And he's been, again, in addition to the Big Men Don't Bully campaign, he does a lot with the NFL character playbook. And again, weekly, he's going out talking to youth and building character. And what I thought one of the greatest things he did, Chris, he bought 20 season tickets himself last year, and he donated all of them to various organizations that are dealing with youth and character-based programs. So every game, there are 20 different tickets that people are seeing games down in Atlanta due to Grady Jarrett buying the season tickets for them. And he's also started one more tradition, Chris. Every Thanksgiving, he has he caters himself and his family. Get this, not just the team. Himself and his family, they cater a full hot Thanksgiving meal to men at a local homeless shelter down in Atlanta. And he does that every year. And he also gives out hats and T-shirts. So that's just terrific stuff. So we're very proud to mention his name, Chris. Grady Jarrett, defensive tackle at Atlanta, we salute you tonight.
Yeah, Bob, kudos to Grady Jarrett of the Falcons for doing what he's doing. And the anti-bullying campaign is something that has been near and dear to our heart since really the inception of this show, and our good friend Nick Lowry doing a lot of things with the anti-bullying campaign. So kudos to Grady Jarrett for doing what he's doing, because important stuff and another great story. Thank you for bringing that one up, Bob. And Bob, after speaking with Leonard tonight, I'm going to stick with the Panthers organization and put my spotlight on Panthers running back Christian McCaffrey. He's making a dream come true for former Army Sergeant Alex Summerson, and by giving he and his wife tickets to the Super Bowl and admission into the Salute to Service Lounge at Mercedes-Benz Stadium that day. And there's going to be several current and former players and coaches, including McCaffrey. They're going to be in that room watching the game. McCaffrey is teaming up with USAA and the Wounded Warrior Project to award this trip to the Super Bowl to Summerson and his wife. And Sergeant Summerson served in the Army from 2004 to 2009. And was twice deployed to Iraq in support of Operation Iraqi Freedom. And during his service, he earned the Combat Infantry Badge, and upon returning home was diagnosed with post-traumatic stress disorder. He's been involved with the Wounded Warrior Project going all the way back to 2011. So hopefully this experience is going to serve as a day filled with a lot of fun events for he and his wife, and he doesn't have to think about anything else going on in his life over the course of the day, and making wonderful memories that he'll be able to look back on and cherish for the rest of his life. And this isn't the first time Christian McCaffrey has participated in this program. He did it last year as well. So, Bob, kudos to Christian McCaffrey and, of course, to Sergeant Summerson. Kudos to him and thanks to him for his service. You know, we can't do enough to show our collective appreciation to members of our troop and to our veterans as well. So, Bob, I thought this was really a combination of two great things. McCaffrey for what he's doing, and our way of saying thank you to an Army sergeant for the tremendous sacrifices that he's made during the course of his life. So more great stuff and another great story here in our Spotlight on the Positive segment, Bob.
Tremendous story, Chris. McCaffrey's a Stanford guy, obviously a very intelligent man, very incredible athlete, and We all know what his father, when his father was here in New York, Chris, considered a very solid citizen. So it's just great to see it just pass to the generation, the importance of doing things like this. And of course, when the military gets involved, we can't do enough or publicize it enough for those guys. So kudos to those guys. Again, our favorite part of the show, because we can leave and go to bed with a smile on our faces, because this is the news that we should read on a daily basis.
Indeed it is. All right, Bob, time for us to put a bow on this edition of Thursday Night Tailgate. We want to send out our thanks again to Tony Collins, Eddie Metter, EJ Jr., and Leonard Wheeler for joining us tonight. And Bob, always such a thrill to spend my Thursday night with you, my friend.
You too. That was a lot of fun, Chris. No pressure on picks tonight, so we'll save the pressure for next week. And we'll look forward to giving our final picks next week and seeing how Tony Collins is doing, et cetera. Who else do we have coming on?
Yeah, next week we're going to welcome back former Steelers defensive back JT Thomas. He'll be back with us, as will former Bengals tight end ML Harris. We'll catch up with LaVon Kirkland. LaVon was scheduled to be with us a couple of weeks ago, had an emergency come up, so we look forward to having him back on the show with us again next week, and working on a couple of other guests. Plus, of course, Tony Collins will be here to go through our Super Bowl picks as well. I want to remind everyone before we close up shop how you can follow us on social media. First, on Facebook, we have a page for the show, Thursday Night Tailgate. Give us a like. That's very important to us. Plus, both Bob and I have our own Facebook pages as well. Please check out our website, ThursdayNightTailgate.com. On there, you'll be able to see what our guest schedule looks like. Plus, we link back to our page over on Podbean, and we can't thank those guys enough for featuring us front and center on the Podbean app in their NFL fan section. And folks, if you love this, listen to podcasts across all genres, download the Podbean app or go online to podbean.com. They've got so many great podcasts available for you on there. On Twitter, you can follow me at CT Mascaro. Bob is at Bob_Lazzari, and the show is at TNT Podcast. Bob, take us home, my friend.
Okay, Chris, I look forward to next week, and we want to thank our announcer, Joe Lajanusa, for the great job he does with our intro and ads. We also want to shout out to Kyle Turley and the Kyle Turley Band for the upcoming outro music. And on behalf of myself and Chris, we want to send out thanks to everyone out there for listening. We appreciate you the most. And until next week, good night, Kevin, and good night, Terry. We miss you guys.
Can't tell the day or time, but I know this day.